never store find. So I don't like shopping at malls. Okay. One, I think they're overpriced. And when you go through a mall, it's almost the same thing store to store. So you're being, you know, this is what's in, this is what everyone should be wearing. I don't want to wear what everyone's wearing. I want to wear what I like, what I gravitate toward. I want to be more into, you know, I don't want to walk in and be wearing the same thing someone else is wearing, especially if they look better in it than I do. That's an awful, awful thing to happen. So I tried a new thrift store. We used to have one that was my favorite, and they closed down years ago, and I've been grieving them. And I've tried Goodwill and Salvation Army. There's several good thrift stores around here, but for clothes, I can buy new on clearance cheaper than I can find at some thrift stores. And you know what I'm talking about. So, saw one on Facebook, not too out of the way of my normal running around. So, I thought I'd check them out. It was very neat. The sizes, a lot of thrift stores, you know, it's women's shirts. It's all women's shirts. Here, they were sized, you know, so just like in a retail store. Everything was neatly displayed. The ladies that were working there were very nice, very friendly. So, I couldn't resist. So, this is one of the tops. It's one of the first ones I picked out, and it's long. Just stand up. Hard to tell. It's a Bob Mackie wearable art shirt. So, I just Googled it a little while ago. And they're not stuff I would have bought at full price, at full retail. But I got this, yellow tags were half off. So all the tops were $3.99, half off $2. So this was a $2 shirt. And little earrings I wore. Here's another $2 find. Okay. Now this, the cut, and it feels nice. It's got a liner inside. L-E-L-L-E. The color is not really my style. I'm not a lacy type person normally, but it was $2, and it looks like a comfortable shirt. So if nothing, you know, we'll see. It may end up back at a thrift store. This is another $2 shirt. I love the feel of it. I know it's polyester. This is actually 95% polyester and 5% spandex. So it feels really soft, but it's a lot more durable, and I like the way it hangs. As much as I enjoy cotton, cotton just doesn't hang like this, almost like a silky. And this will be a nice, you know, I got some a brown something I can wear underneath it for long sleeves if I wanted to wear it right now. $2. Another summer top. This steps me out of, I was trying to get away from patterns, but I think this will go nicely with some of my black skirts and bottoms I'm getting. These are all going to be long. My bottom will be covered by shirt and pants. So, and this doesn't gap, but I still probably wear something underneath. Or wear one of those little, you know, connect to the bra thing that looks like you're wearing one. Because it's too hot to layer here during the summer. This was a $2 item. I know, I said I was going to get away from autumn colors, but... Okay, I should just work on getting away from the scrub tops. I'm actually going to take my scrub tops out of my closet, the ones I'm keeping, and folding them and putting them in a location where they're not so easy to grab. Because they're not going to be in my high priority, you know, easy to, you know, where I'm looking at stuff. But I like this 3/4 length sleeve again. And it feels good. I'm not sure what the material on this is. But it feels really good. And the bottom, so you know, tuck it or leave it out. I did get some black and white stuff. I couldn't resist. This was another $2 item. I like the way this is flowy. I can wear this out. And I really have a preference towards square necks. This one, it's cotton. Still, I washed them and hung them up. Still a little damp, thick. I don't know how well that would go, but that may be flattering on my figure or not, but it's kind of, that goes with a lot of stuff I have. This is a Talbert's tunic. I like that, the embroidery, the neckline. It feels good, the 3/4 length sleeve. Vertical. Okay, at least these are vertical. I like the difference in there. If I wear this open, you'll see this, it's lined with the polka dots on the inside, vertical. It's got, so I like that. And another button down with the darting, front and back. This is a, glasses for this one. Apartment 9. I'm not familiar with that. Brands don't, some of the name brands do make a better quality, you know, doesn't look like it's already been washed 100 times. You know what brands I'm talking about that's like that. It's like if, I shouldn't have to pay the same price for something with quality that already looks like it's not going to last me that long because it's already been, you know, just thin fabrics. So, if you've been counting, this and the 9 I showed you, that's 10. I bought 12. Okay. I found this, $4. It is too cold right now for me to wear this, unless I wear like a turtleneck underneath it. It's nice. Cotton. Feels good. It's cute. I would not pay retail for this. I don't really see them like this. They're more house dressy with sleeves and stuff, but I couldn't resist. I saw it $4, but okay. Summertime. And it's a night shirt. It's long. Doesn't button down all the way. But one pocket. Long. Full sleeve. I'm sleeping in this tonight. Cotton, that feels good. Roundtree and York. I don't know. And books. I am a bibliophile. And as much as I love my audiobooks, so I can get things done, my husband's not gonna do that. And he likes to take his time. He can put a book down no matter what's going on. He can put it down. I can't. It's like I gotta see what happens. I can't leave my friend in that position. I gotta see how it ends. You know, that's how it... So I like the Lee Child, if you Jack Reacher movie that Tom Cruise is now doing. Jack Reacher in the book is a big man. He's like really big. And a lot of people see him and they think he's stupid because he's just brawn, no brains. But he's, I love the way this author explains how he thinks and how he does, you know, why he reacts the way he reacts. So I thought, okay. I started this series already on audio, but they don't have the other audios available. And I saw the books. So I thought, okay, I don't know how long it's going to take me to read these, but I thought this was a pretty neat series. Crossed and Reached. Can't remember the first one. Another 2 more Jack Reacher books and hardback. Hardbacks were $1, paperbacks were 50 cents, another $1. And, you've ever seen the Dresden Files TV series, the book. I love the humor. It's nothing like the, it is sort of like the series, but the vampires and stuff are, TV has beautified vampires. The female vampire that in the series he hooks up with, he would never hook up with that in real life because he was able to see what she really looked like. It was a glamour, that beauty. She was not attractive in reality at all. So that's my thrift store find. So I spent $45 on 12, 10 tops, 2 nightgowns, $36, and then $7 on books. And eventually they'll get rehomed. These are not books I plan on keeping. Just read them, send them out. I don't have to worry about late fees with the library. I was bad about returning things on time for some reason. So certain books I just, and then the panic, you know, oh, I got to turn this in. And if you can't renew it because someone else is wanting to read it, so you have this panic thing of, you know, sitting there. And when I'm reading a book like that, it encourages me not to do anything else but read. And when I'm reading, I can't do anything else. So I got some more books at the thrift, at the library too. And they had 50 cent books, hardback, whatever, it's 50 cents. So I brought home 11 books yesterday. Yeah. And the stuff from the thrift store. But you'll be amazed. I mean, $4 for a sofa desk. That was actually a computer. It has a computer drawer, so it has a little thing that flops down. I plan on putting my laptop in there and actually doing that in the living room so that I'm, right now my husband and I are opposite ends of the house most of the time. So I'm trying to make things a little bit more cozy. But I'm excited. What do you think about my finds? Did you like any of them? What do you think, you know? The color's not bad on me, but like I said, I'm not a lace person, but it's nice. And this top, makes me think of scrapbooking. Like doing a page like that, paper. Or, you know, getting white paper and blue die cuts and then bordering that with brown. So it's like inspiration for a scrapbook page. Should I be wearing that? I could wear that scrapbooking. And see, with the dark collar, it's not washing me out so badly. What do you think? These are things I like the cut of. I like the feel. And I am that kinesthetic. I did say it right in the video. How something feels is very important. So even though if this was the same in every which way, but it was cotton, it wouldn't feel quite right. It wouldn't feel, if it was different materials, if it was all 100% polyester, it would be a break. I wouldn't like it. So how it feels, even this, I like the way this just feels on my fingers. And then, you know, it's not, I don't have to worry about flashing anybody. And ladies, be careful when you bend over. Even though this, you know, right there is not going to show anything, when you bend over, this is going to look. So, I'm conscious of that kind of stuff. When I bend over, it's like I'm not holding my chest in. It's the shirt. And I just think that's polite. I've noticed women doing that. I don't care to see it. It does not look attractive, no matter what. Age, whatever. Bra, no bra. Just coming out. So a lot of these things, like this one may be too low. And I'm wearing, even though it's not going to show anything, you know, no cleavage even at this height, I'm still going to wear that something underneath it. Because I just feel more comfortable. I can move around and not feel like I'm flashing or I just don't want to deal with that. So, anyway, what do you think about my nightgowns? I would like to Juliet this thing. One of the things I got from the auction this weekend was a box of assorted laces. I know I said I'm not a lace person. And as long as it's not interfering with my sleep, I like the whole romantic Juliet thing. I would maybe do something different. I can sew, dig the sewing machine out, and make this a little bit more feminine. Because this could almost, you know, a man could wear this, I think. The buttons? Maybe it is a man's. It could be. The buttons are on the other side. I'm having fun. Once or twice a year, I'll go out and spend $100, $200 on clothes. At a good deal. It's like I come home with bags. And I've done that at various stores, from Sears, because Sears used to have it's been a while since I've gone there. And like I said, it's been years since I've gone into a, stepped foot into a mall. But during the seasons change, you can go in and get some incredible deals. And that's what I've done. When I've caught those, it's like I call up my husband and go, hey, can I do that? You know, is that okay? I'm finding some great. He's like, yeah, because I don't. What some women spend on one outfit, I'm spending that on several items once a year. And I am still in the back of my mind. I got some things like some of my mom's clothes tends to be more business, professional looking clothes, even though I don't know, she never wore those. I don't remember seeing her in any of that. But I was like, if I go back into the office, I want to have some nice things also that's not just professional looking. These are things I would wear to church. I really like this. I can't wait to wear this one. I know that feels, of all the ones I picked out, this one was my favorite. It's the first one I found, and it was $2, so I was like, oh, I bit that hook big time. And I want to take my husband back there. He likes thrift storing too, because he finds the best shirts, nice quality stuff that he literally wears for years until they're like wore out. And he's like, $1. My $1 shirt. I was like, honey, we gotta retire that. It's getting holes. So we went out recently and he bought 5 shirts, $5. But the place that he normally goes to, he has to do some digging. It's not as neat as this place. I think he'll like it. It's going to be more, he's going to be complaining about the $4 charge on a shirt. I know him. But I'm going to go back and look for some dresses. And I didn't, that's where I kind of cut it close. It's like, oh, alarm goes off, get to the checkout. And then got stopped by a train trying to leave the parking lot. Nowhere to go. Had to wait. Couldn't. I was like, is there no? So, yeah. What do you think? That's my style. That's what I like. I do need to get away from the black and white. I need to weed out some more of the black and white stuff I have. And stick with stuff I actually really love and actually wear. So I'm going to put some of the other stuff away, donate it, and the stuff I'm actually going to keep, that, like the scrub tops, they're going to just go into a drawer. I'm not a drawer person, so I know where they're at, and I can pull them out when I need them. But I shouldn't be running around in them. Even if I'm just staying around the house, I'm not going anywhere. I think it's important. I'm really working on how I'm looking. Thanks for watching.